posted April 29, 2018, 12 hours, 0 minutes and 0 seconds. PM MDT updated April 29, 2018, 12 hours, 23 minutes and 59 seconds. PM MDT people applying deodorant to start their day could be contributing a comparable level of chemicals to the atmosphere as they do when getting in their cars and driving to work. That's the conclusion of a new study published on Wednesday, led by Matthew Coggon, a research scientist who works with the University of Colorado's Cooperative Institute for Research in Environmental Sciences at Boulder's National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. The research upon which the new study was based was taken from data recorded in both Boulder and Toronto, detailing the emissions of volatile organic compounds, FOX, from personal care products such as deodorants, lotions and antiperspirants. Those products react in the atmosphere with nitrogen oxides and other compounds to form ozone and particulate matter, which influence air quality and can have health consequences. Such healthcare products evaporate rapidly and emit picam-ethylcyclopentasiloxane, a mouthful known as D5, or siloxane. Each person emits between 100 and 200 milligrams per day of D5, according to NOAA, which has a long lifespan and can move globally. D5 has been found in the Arctic, in the ocean, in women's breast milk and even in the livers of Atlantic cod. Coggon and his team made real-time measurements of ambient D5 in Boulder in 2015 and 2017, and also analyzed samples collected previously in Toronto. They found in both cities that the D5 emission rate is comparable to the emission rate of benzene, which is a marker of vehicle emissions. Their findings show that although people use nearly 15 times more fuel than household products, chemicals in everyday healthcare products contribute just as much to VOC emissions in the early part of the day. It peaks in the morning and then decays as it off-gases off your body, and it's of similar magnitude to benzene, Coggon said. It's going to be highest in the morning, and then slowly decay throughout the day. The morning and afternoon peaks are going to be somewhat comparable. The big thing is that when you initially apply it and go out to drive in the morning, those two emission rates, D5 and benzene, are going to be comparable, the stunning piece of new study, published Wednesday in Environmental Science. That earlier work by McDonald, who is also a contributor to Coggon's new study, used chemical modeling of atmospheric chemistry measurements taken in Los Angeles to show that household products produce roughly 50% of the VOC emissions measured there, which is evidence that the impact of household products on VOC emissions is more than previously suspected. Coggon's team's study supports those findings. We estimate for the city of Boulder, it's about 3 to 5 kilograms per day of siloxane, D5, and benzene, from motor vehicles, we estimate is about 15 kilograms, Coggon said. So it's about 3 to 5 times lower than vehicles, in terms of total mass. But the emissions that you see in the morning, they're fairly close, which is the stunning piece. You driving your car, you're emitting as much siloxane as your vehicle is emitting benzene. That's the general gist. What's not yet known is what the health effects of the emissions from personal care products might be. We don't really know the toxicity of this compound, and from our standpoint, it's not that D5 is a toxin in the air that it's a major pollutant, Coggon said. It's a marker for a really important source of pollution, which are consumer products. So, if we see this compound in the atmosphere, we know that air parcel was impacted by people's deodorant, hair gels and other things. And there's a whole litany of other compounds that are associated with this that we just don't know enough about yet. We're going to be able to do research for the next 10 years, trying to figure out what are the impacts of people putting on their deodorant. Truth-checking study is the product of data collected and analyzed through Coggon's mass spectrometer and gas chromatography mass spectrometry instrumentation overseen by Jessica Gilman, a NOAA research chemist and co-author on the new study. The next phase of their work will include analysis of data already being collected in New York City, which by virtue of its far larger and denser development alone promises to provide a rich array of emissions and scientific discovery for the researchers. Having identified siloxane as a marker for personal care products, Gilman said, "Can we find a specific marker that's for paint and adhesives? Can we find one that's specific to some other kind of building materials? That way, we can start to get a better look at these emissions inventories. They may not have intrinsic air quality impacts, but they are extremely useful for the sciences to start doing truth checking on a lot of these different emissions inventories and chemical products." Charlie Brennan, 303-473-1327, BrenninkDailyCamera.com or Twitter.com/ChasBrennan.